Good morning, class. I hope you all are doing well and focusing on your studies, and I hope all of your tests were good and you all scored very good marks in English and OC. So we had seen personal account. The rules of personal account was debit the receiver, credit the giver. Now we are going to see real account. The rule of real account, for that you need to remember, the real account consists of goods and assets, right? So goods and assets, why we are using goods? Because purchase goods of rupees 2000, so goods comes in, so goods are your asset in one shot, but we write purchase, right? So that's why goods and assets. So your real account consists of goods and assets. Debit what comes in, credit what goes out, is the rule of what we say, your real account. Debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Debit what comes in, credit what goes out. If goods or asset comes in business, debit respective goods or asset account, and if goods or assets goes out from the business, it is credit respective goods account. Now see, goods of 20,000 purchased from Rohini. So here you can see word goods and purchase are there. So we don't write goods account, we write purchase account. So what are coming in? Goods are coming in. So goods comes in. And who is the giver? Rohini. As we are learning for real account, so we focus on real account only. So goods of 20,000 purchased from Rohini. So first account affected is goods and purchase. Both are same. We don't write goods account, we write purchase account. So purchase account is debited. Why? Because goods comes in. You can see over here. Goods of 2000 purchased from Rohini, goods comes in, purchase account will be debited. Is it clear? So next statement is, goods of 8000 purchased from Salma on cash. Students, first of all, in first transaction only one Rohini was there, so it was a credit transaction. But in second transaction, name of a person is also given and cash is given, so it is a cash transaction. So here two accounts are affected that are real. See, goods of 8000 purchased from Salma on cash. So which account is affected? Goods and purchase and cash also. We should learn from the beginning only goods, purchase and cash. Why? Goods comes in because we had purchased. So purchase account is debiting. The reason of debiting purchase account is goods comes in. So purchase account is debiting. And when we purchase on cash, what goes out? Cash goes out, so cash account is credited. See, but here, goods of 8000 purchased from Salma on cash, goods comes in, purchase account will be debited. Is it clear? And again, I'm repeating, it is not given in the books, but for your basic knowledge, I'm saying cash again is a real account, so cash goes out. So cash account is credited. You just understand what does it mean. A transaction has double effect, and in this transaction there are two accounts that are real account and they are having same effect, that is debit and credit. Debit what comes in, credit what goes out. So debit what comes in, what is coming in? Goods, but we don't write goods, we write purchase. So purchase account is debited, and what goes out? Cash goes out. If the Salma was there, so it would be personal account. So we would have taken personal account, we'll see earlier, right? Furniture of 10,000 purchased from Rajesh. So it is purchased from Rajesh. So it is a credit transaction. So which account is affected? For real account, we are focusing furniture and purchase. So when we purchase anything other than goods, listen to me carefully. When we purchase anything other than goods, it is treated as asset. Not purchase or sale. again I am repeating, those who will listen, they focus on my words. When we purchase anything else other than goods, it is asset. It is not written as purchase or sale. So here, furnishing and purchase accounts are underlined, but here, furniture comes in. What comes in? Furniture comes in. So furniture account is debited. You can see. Furniture is an asset. I said you earlier, anything else is purchased other than goods is treated as asset. So furniture is your asset. So furniture is purchased, but here purchase is there. Furniture again, I'm repeating, the furniture is purchased, right? From Rajesh. So Rajesh is a credit transaction because name of a person is given. But when we purchase, again I'm repeating, when we purchase anything else other than goods, it is treated as asset. So here your furniture becomes an asset. So furniture becomes new, furniture is already an asset. So furniture is an asset. So furniture, reason furniture comes in. So furniture account will be debited. Is it clear? हम परचेज करते हैं कोई और चीज जो गुड्स नहीं है जिसमें हम बिजनेस कर रहे हैं तो उसको हम असेट ट्रीट करते हैं, इसलिए उसके नाम से ही लिखते हैं, चाहे वो व्हीकल हो, फर्नीचर हो, लैंड एंड बिल्डिंग हो, गुडविल हो, इज इट क्लियर, मशीनरी हो, राइट. लेकिन जब हम गुड्स परचेज करते हैं तो हम उसको गुड्स नहीं लिखते, उसको परचेज लिखते हैं. वैसे ही जब हम सेल करते हैं तो हम उसको गुड्स नहीं लिखते, उसको सेल लिखते हैं. इज इट क्लियर? मशीन परचेज ऑन कैश, क्लियरली मेंशन, इट इज अ कैश ट्रांजेक्शन. सो व्हाट इज मशीन इज परचेज ऑन कैश. क्लियर? द वर्ड परचेज डजंट मैटर टू अस इन टर्म्स ऑफ नेमिंग द अकाउंट, बट व्हेन वी परचेज मशीन in cash, again two accounts are affected, cash account and machine account. So machine purchase, so machine comes in, so machine account is debited. You can see over here, you can see machine of 20,000 purchased in cash, machine comes in, machine is an asset, machine account will be debited. Is it clear? Goods of 20,000 sold to Rohini. So here comes sales, goods and sold, right? So goods goes out. When we say your goods goes out, so sales account will be credited. Is it clear? Goods of 8,000 sold to Salma on cash, right? Goods of 8,000 sold to Salma on cash. It is a credit transaction. So here, when you sell goods, goods goes out, and as per real account, debit what comes in, credit what goes out. What goes out? Goods. But we don't write goods. We write sale. So sales account will be credited. All furniture 10,000 sold to Rajesh. Now, when our as goods are sold, so we write sales. And when goods are purchased, we write purchase. In the same way, when any other asset is purchased, that is furniture, machine, land and building, we write name of that asset. So when it is sold, then also we write the name of that asset only. We don't write as sales account. So old furniture 10,000 sold to Rajesh. When we sell anything, so what goes out? That thing goes out. Asset goes out, right? So furniture goes out. Furniture account is credited. You can see machine of 20,000 sold on cash. Machine, when it was purchased, we had written purchase. Machine account is debited. Machine comes in. In the same way, when we sell, machine goes out. So machine account is credited. So these were your real account, nominal account, nominal and then nominal account. There comes all the expenses and income, right? All the expenses and losses, all the incomes and gains. See, rule of nominal account, debit all expenses and losses, credit all incomes and gains. Again, I'm repeating, debit all expenses and losses, credit all incomes and gains. 5,000 paid for salary. Whenever the word paid is given, whenever the word paid is given, always remember it means cash is paid. Paisa gaya. So here we are focusing on nominal account. So we see the nominal account only. We will not focus on cash, we will focus on salary. Paid yani ke hamari liability nahi hai, it is an expense. So salary accounts, debit all expenses and losses, credit all incomes and gains. Right? So what happens? Wait a minute. So what happens? Your salary is an expense, so debit all expenses and losses. So salary account is debited. Then 3,000 paid for rent. Again, I'm just helping you so you remember what is to be returned. 3,000 paid for rent. So paid means cash transaction. So 3,000 paid for rent. So rent is an expense, debit all expenses. So rent account is debited. Reason, rent is a expense. Paid telephone bill. Again, paid telephone bill. So cash goes out and cash transaction. So telephone bill is your expense. So telephone bill account is debited. Bad debts incurred for business. Bad debts are your bad debts are your losses. So debit all expenses and losses, so it goes to debit side. Bad debts account is debited, and bad debt is our expense. No, bad debt is our loss. Bad debt account is debited because bad debt is a loss of the business, right? The next, brokerage received. Here you can see the word here you can see the word received. What does it mean? It is a cash transaction. So brokerage is received. Is it clear? So debit all expenses and losses, credit all incomes and gain. So your brokerage received means it is your income. So we are going to credit. brokerage account is brokerage is what we say income. So brokerage account is credited. Dividend received, again the word received, so it is a cash transaction. Whenever you see the word received, it is a cash transaction. So dividend is an income. What is the rule of nominal account? Debit all the expenses and losses, credit all incomes and gains. So dividend is an income, so dividend account is to be credited. Commission received 8,000. So again received word signifies cash transaction. So commission received. So what are the rule of nominal account? Debit all expenses and losses, credit all incomes and gains. So it is your income. So commission is an income, so its commission account is to be credited. Interest received, again the word received, so it is a cash transaction. Is it clear? So here we had completed two illustrations related to real account and nominal account. Rules of debit and credit is given to you. See, here to which account the following transaction will be debited and credited. अभी तक आपने एक transaction का एक ही effect देखा था, second नहीं देखा. अब आपको दोनों effect देखने हैं. यानी कि रियल अकाउंट भी रियल नॉमिनल अकाउंट भी हो सकता है, रियल पर्सनल अकाउंट भी हो सकता है, पर्सनल नॉमिनल अकाउंट भी हो सकता है, रियल रियल अकाउंट भी हो सकता है. आया समझ में? कैसे होगा देखते हैं. टू विच अकाउंट द फॉलोइंग ट्रांजैक्शन विल बी डेबिटेड एंड क्रेडिटेड इन द बुक्स ऑफ रणछोड़ डिस्क्राइब. सो स्टूडेंट्स इंस्टेड ऑफ गोइंग इन दिस फॉर्मेट गो विथ दिस फॉर्मेट राइट. आई एम ड्रॉइंग so you don't get confused. Wait, let me cancel that. This pattern is not to be written. Is it clear? I'm clearly mentioning you. This pattern is not to be written, right? So I'm canceling it. Let us see. First, so in the books of Ranchor, you will write with the heading. And Ranchor commenced business with the capital of 50,000. What happens, students, whenever a business is started? So what comes in? Cash comes in, and when an owner brings any amount for business, it is termed as capital. Remember, so two accounts are affected: cash account and capital account. So how you will identify? Read the transaction. Ranchor commenced business with the capital of rupees 50,000. So we know very well capital is one account and another is cash account. So let us see cash. Now we will see the word cash is not given. When it is not given and the word capital is given, so it is treated as cash only. So cash account and capital account. When we start a business, cash is coming in. So cash is a real account and capital is a personal account because owner is a giver. Owner is a giver. So first account, cash account. Cash account is a which kind of account? Real account. Capital account, it's a which kind of account? Personal account. So here rules of real account and personal accounts are applicable. How we are going to apply? Here, real accounts, listen, debit what comes in, credit what goes out. When a business is started, cash comes in. So cash account, debit. You don't need to go for credit because another account is not real account. Another account is personal account, that is capital account. So capital account is to be credited by personal accounts rule. Debit the receiver, credit the giver. Here you can see you will make two columns. So this pattern is to be followed by you. Is it clear? I had just said to you this pattern is to be followed by you. Yes, students, again I'm doing it. This is the pattern that you are going to do. And that one, your head cancel. I change the color first. Otherwise, you will get confused. Okay. Yes, so this one, pattern you will follow. You will prepare two columns in the books of Ranchod heading. First column will be always for debit one, debit effect. Second column will be of credit effect. Is it clear? So step by step, first of all recognize whether it's a cash transaction or credit transaction. Means cash transaction or credit transaction. That then find out which accounts are affected. Name them. Then, whichever the accounts are affected, they are of which type of account? Real account, nominal account, personal account. And then apply the rules. So here we have seen cash comes in. Right? Cash comes in. It's a real account. So cash account is debited. Owner gave the capital to the business, so owner is a giver. Capital account is credited. Is it clear, students? So second transaction is, as I don't have virtual textbook, I am going through question and then showing you answers. 20,000 deposited with the Bank of Baroda. 20,000 deposited with the Bank of Baroda. So 20,000 is where cash is not given, but obviously cash is only deposited. So which account is affected? Cash and deposited with the Bank of Baroda. In suppose a Bank of Baroda account is there and in that 20,000 is deposited. So, first of all, it is a cash transaction. Yes, it is a cash transaction. So, which account are affected? Bank of Baroda account and cash account. Why? Why Bank of Baroda? I had said first because Bank of Baroda is a personal account. Personal account's rule is debit the receiver, credit the giver. Again, I'm repeating, debit the receiver, credit the giver. Bank of Baroda is a personal account, artificial identity, remember? So, Bank of Baroda is a receiver. So, Bank of Baroda account is debited and deposited. Yani, humare paas se kya gaya? Cash gaya. So, cash account is credited, cash goes out. You can see. Bank has received a cash, so bank account is debited. Cash goes out from the business, so cash account is credited. Is it clear? Third transaction, goods of 2000 purchased on cash. Now here two accounts are affected, students. Pay attention over here. Here two accounts are affected. First of all, purchase goods and cash. Now we will say, teacher, you are marking three accounts and saying two accounts are affected because whenever goods are purchased, whenever goods are purchased means we are dealing in that particular goods, right? And that's why we write purchase word for them. Whenever we write whenever we purchase or sell our business related product, that words are used as purchase or sales. We don't use goods. So goods account is affected because goods comes in. But which account is to be debited? Goods account? No, we will write purchase account is debited. When we purchase on cash, see, you go on shop and you purchase on cash, so the goods are coming in, so we write purchase account is debited, right? And what you are giving to the shopkeeper? Cash. Cash goes out. Now you can see over here, purchase account is debited, goods comes in. Right? So purchase account is debited. Good. Cash goes out from business, so cash account is credited. So I'm stopping over here. And yes, I got today 2-3 entries. And unfortunately, for some reason, all the my data has been lost. So I'm so sorry for the students, those who had sent me there. What we say, teacher, we like to do this, we like to do that. I was happy to get answers from you, and I'm so sorry I was not able to answer to many of you, because till now my data has not been started, my mobile has not been started, so sorry for that. Then also happy to see all of you being creative, right? So don't stop your passion, continue with your passion and focus on studies also, right? Till then, take care, bye bye.